Imagine a ranch with three enterprises: cow-calf, stocker, and a hay enterprise. How would you lay out the accounts and allocate costs to evaluate the profitability of the different parts of this business? The approach we take at the Ranching for Profit School is very different than the conventional approach. But using our approach, you won't need a team of university specialists to find your profit drivers or your dead wood. We don't crunch the numbers as an academic exercise. We do it to give you immediate, actionable information. Now, we start by grouping enterprises into divisions. A division is simply a group of enterprises that share similar overhead costs. Overheads include your land and labor costs. Here we put our cow-calf and stocker enterprises in a cattle division. Our hay enterprise would have different overheads, so we put it in a farming division. Even though it's still only one enterprise, we would put it in its own division, because we don't allocate overhead costs to enterprises. But under some circumstances, they can be allocated to a division. So here's how we put the numbers together. We start by estimating the production that we'll get from each enterprise and make some reasonable guesses about the prices we think we'll receive. That gives us the information we need to project gross product. That's the value that each enterprise produces. Now, we ought to be able to make some reasonable predictions about our direct costs. Direct costs are the costs that change directly as we change the scale of the enterprise. More animals means more feed. So, we estimate how much mineral, how much vaccine, how many ear tags we'll need for the cow-calf enterprise and the stocker enterprise. We also need to make some decent guesses about the direct costs that we'll incur in the hay enterprise. We subtract the direct costs for each enterprise from the gross product for that enterprise to calculate the enterprise gross margin. We determine the division gross margin by adding the gross margins of all the enterprises in each division. Now, what about overheads? Any overheads that are unique to a division should be allocated to that division. In other words, if 100% of the overhead can be allocated, go ahead and allocate it. Here's the test. If you stop doing the division, would you lose 100% of the cost? If the answer is yes, if you'd lose 100% of the cost, then you can allocate the overhead to that division. But if the answer is no, if you'd still have at least some of that cost, you cannot allocate that overhead or any part of it to a division. Now, everyone you have ever talked to about this sort of thing has probably advised you to allocate all of your costs, including your overheads, to the enterprises or divisions that incurred those costs, even if it means splitting the costs between divisions. On the surface, that may make sense. But when you dive into the numbers, it makes the analysis extremely difficult. So, here's an example of exactly what not to do. Let's say that we have a tractor that we use 70% on the farming side and 30% on the livestock side of the business. Depreciation and interest on that tractor are overhead costs. Most people would split that cost, allocating 70% to the farming and 30% to the cattle. Don't do it. The rule is, when divisions share overhead costs, those costs should not be allocated to either division. So if you don't allocate that cost to a division, where does it go? Good question. I'll show you. So let's pick up things where we left off. So start by subtracting the divisional overheads from the divisional gross margin. That gives us divisional profit or loss. Add up the division profit or loss from each division, and then subtract all of the other overhead costs in the business, including those that were shared between divisions. We call those business overheads. Most of the overhead costs in your business will probably be business overheads. So, once we subtract the business overheads, we have our projection of business profit or loss. When in doubt, don't allocate the overhead. Allocating overhead costs to the divisions gives us a mistaken notion that the numbers will have more meaning. But all it does is make the process harder and the analysis more difficult. Worse yet, it leads us to the wrong conclusions. If you're ranching for profit, you will either allocate overhead costs completely or not at all.